Looking at this model, the most prominent feature is this protrusion right here. It starts level with the general surface and then gradually rises up to the opposite side. From the top, the feature has a semicircular shape. Looking from the side, the feature follows a somewhat straight path. To get a maximum benefit from this video, I would encourage all viewers to pause this video right here and try to think about how you would approach this. Let's remove the fillets. The general strategy here is to build a patchwork of surfaces for the protrusion. Let's take a look at a feature from the top, which I'll start by sketching two arcs that correspond to these two edges. Begin a sketch on the top plane. Begin the center point arc command. Snap the first point to the origin. With the dimension field active, key in the radius value. Enter and start moving the cursor to the opposite side. At this point, the angle dimension field appears. Enter an angle of 180 degrees and enter. Although the sketch has turned black, it is still not fully defined. If you try to drag one of the endpoints, the arc still moves. If you adjust the angle dimension, we can see a center line. Click on this center line and impose a horizontal constraint. Let's create an offset of this arc. Next, we want to create the side profile of this edge. If you look at this from the front plane, this is actually a straight line. Create a sketch on the front plane. Snap one end of the line to this point and end the other point somewhere here. Click on the horizontal vertical constraint and select these two points. Fusion would analyze the relative positions of the points and set a vertical constraint. Define a height for this point. We are going to use the straight line and this arc and project them onto one another. This will create this edge on a finished model. Since this will be a 3D sketch, we can start a sketch on any plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersection Curve. Select the arc and a straight line. You can see a preview of the resultant curve in red. This resultant curve matches both the arc on the top plane and a straight line on the front plane. Confirm the sketch. Now is a good time to name the sketches. Let's hide the straight line and the projected line. Let's take a look at the finished model. For this inside edge, we will be going through the same steps. Again, begin a sketch on the front plane. This time, we will snap to the end point of the inner arc. Unhide the first straight line and impose a horizontal constraint between these two points. Again, create an intersection curve using the inner arc and the new straight line. unhide all but the two projected lines. Create a sketch on the front plane and sketch in lines to close up the endpoints. To create this surface, we shall use the Loft command. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Loft. Select the two straight lines as our profiles. For rails, click on the Select box and select the two projected curves. Confirm the operation. Unhide the two arcs created at the beginning. We shall use these two arcs to create extruded surfaces which will serve as side walls of the feature. Go to Create, Extrude. Pick on the two arcs and extrude beyond the lofted surface. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the lofted surface as the trim tool and click on the unwanted sections of the surfaces. Create a sketch on the front plane and create a line to join these two points. Go to Create, Patch. Uncheck the chaining option and select these four edges to patch up this end of the feature. At this point, the feature is not entirely closed off yet. It is still open at the bottom. Repeat the patch surface command. Select the open edges to close this off. Now that we have a watertight surface body, let's go to Modify, Stitch. Select all the surfaces and stitch this into a solid body. The most challenging part of the model is complete. The next step is to create the circular base. Next, add in some fillets. Activate the Solid tab, go to Modify, Down. Select the bottom surface and adjust the thickness.